नमस्कार दोस्तों, FII के वीकली प्रोग्राम टॉक विद एन एक्सपर्ट के इस एपिसोड में आप सबका स्वागत है। दोस्तों, हर हफ्ते हम आपके समक्ष किसी न किसी इंडस्ट्री एक्सपर्ट को लेकर आते हैं। आज हमारे बीच मिस्टर पंकज धवन हैं, जो बहुत ही डायनेमिक पर्सनैलिटी हैं, एक कामयाब एंटरप्रेन्योर हैं और हम सबके लिए इंस्पिरेशन हैं, और खासतौर से उन स्टूडेंट्स के लिए ये एक मॉरल है जो ओवरसीज जाके अपना कैरियर बनाना चाहते हैं। हम सबकी तमन्ना होती है कि हम ओवरसीज जाके अपना कैरियर बनाएं। हम उसके लिए एजुकेशन के लिए भी बाहर जाते हैं, जॉब भी अप्लाई करते हैं और एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप के लिए भी कोशिश करते हैं, लेकिन अक्सर मिसगाइडेंस होने की वजह से या प्रॉपर गाइडेंस ना होने की वजह से हम अपने मुकाम पर नहीं पहुँच पाते। तो ऐसे में, ऐसी टफ सिचुएशन में एक कामयाब एंटरप्रेन्योर बनना एक बहुत बड़ी बात है। तो आज हम पंकज जी की जर्नी आप सबसे शेयर करेंगे और उनसे गाइडेंस लेंगे। पंकज जी, आज के इस एपिसोड में आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है। नमस्कार।
थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर हैविंग मी ऑन दिस शो।
इट्स अवर ऑनर टू हैव यू ऑन अवर शो। एंड प्रोग्राम की शुरुआत करने से पहले मैं डॉक्टर गगा जैन जी से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि वो इंट्रोडक्शन के साथ प्रोग्राम की शुरुआत करें।
गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी, नमस्कार। आवर गेस्ट स्पीकर फॉर टुडे मिस्टर पंकज धवन, ही इज एन एंटरप्रेन्योर बेस्ड इन पेरिस सिंस 2006। ही इज करंटली सर्विंग एज द फाउंडर ऑफ 4 कंपनीज, वेंचर कैपिटल फर्म, एन आईटी कंसल्टिंग फर्म एंड 2 रियल एस्टेट कंपनीज। And we are honored to also have him as the Vice President of FII France Chapter. Namaskar, sir. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Namaskar, Gurveji.
आज प्रोग्राम शुरू करने से पहले मैं आपसे रिक्वेस्ट करूंगी कि अपनी जर्नी के बारे में कुछ बताएं।
So I'll start with the greetings. Thank you very much for having me on this show. It's an honor for me. Journey start करूंगा. I think I should start with my childhood. So I was born and brought up in India, in a city called Kurukshetra in Haryana. So Kurukshetra ke bare mein to aapne suna hi hoga. It's a city where Mahabharat was fought and Bhagavad Gita, you know, lessons were delivered by Lord Krishna to Arjun. So main Kurukshetra se hoon. Most of my schooling was done in Kurukshetra only. I would say my childhood was relatively quite challenging and struggling, because I was not even 9 years old when my father lost his job. So me and my sister, we had to go many years in the financial, you know, crisis. So we couldn't study in good schools, like I studied in DAV school of my city, which was in Hindi medium until 10th standard. CBSE mein nahi pad paye. I got married in 10th. I wanted to study in a private school for my non-medical, but I couldn't go there because it was very expensive. So I had to choose a school, you know, which kind of offered me 100% scholarship. So, when I look into, you know, retrospective, I think that was probably the time my, you know, career was getting shaped into aspects, I would say. One is that, you know, very early I learned the lesson that, you know, you don't get anything, you know, easily in life. You have to fight for it and you have to put the hard work. And second is that, you know, I would say I got many lessons from my dad. He's a role model for me. So he fought 13 years legal battles in India to get his job back. He was winning at every stage of legal battle, but the other party was very strong, and finally he had to wait for the Supreme Court verdict, you know, to get his job back. And during his 13 years, he did many things. So to me, he is an entrepreneur. Even though he failed many a times, But one thing I learned was that, you know, he never stopped. Even after failing many times, he got up again with the same rigor, you know, same passion, and then he did many things in life. So I would say he probably did 7-8 ventures in his this 13 years of his career. I think the seed of entrepreneurship was sown at that time. I would say that. Okay. Anyway, I'll just go forward in my narration to complete my journey. So I did my engineering in electrical from CR State College of Engineering. It's a deemed university today, and I did my engineering in electrical. I chose electrical simply because I didn't know much, you know. So most of my decisions were taken by my father. He decided, okay, you should become an engineer, because my mother didn't want me to become a doctor. Anyway, I did my engineering. I got placed in, it was an IT boom at that time. In 2004, I completed my engineering. So I was campus placed by Tata Consulting Services. So I didn't know much about IT at that time, but thankfully we were trained. We were sent to Coimbatore for 2 months by TCS. So I learned many things in IT. I came back to Gurgaon. My first posting was in Gurgaon, and I was given a project in the financial domain. So, well, you know, like many other people, I started my journey in IT. And you see the difference. From electrical, I shifted to IT, and from IT to, I was shifting to finance because I was working in financial domain. So electrical was not my cup of tea. IT again was not my cup of tea. I thought, finance is probably I would like most. So I did some, trainings in IT, in finance, and I started learning French also, because international languages we had to learn during our training in TCS. So I started learning French, and thankfully I got an opportunity to come to France in 2006. So that was my start of my journey in France. So I was working for different clients through TCS, and until 2015 I continued working directly or indirectly in the IT domain in the financial sector. And I took a break from my professional career in 2015. So I decided, it's good that I'm, I studied in India. I started working in India for a big IT company, and I came to France. I was very lucky. But somewhere I was not happy, because I was thinking I'm not doing what I'm supposed to do in life. Okay, so I took a break. I traveled across different cities in the world. I traveled in India, many cities. I also went to mountains, and I became a yoga teacher. And I don't know it's because of yoga or something else, but some wisdom came to me, and a lot of courage also came to me. I came back to France. I started doing again what I was doing before taking a break, but this time I was very courageous, and I said goodbye to what I was doing, and I decided that this is enough. I have to do like my dad did. I have to do things that I want to do, even if there are going to be many difficulties in my life, but I have to do it. And I took this decision, and I started my entrepreneurship journey in 2017. So I started with my first company, MindLab. It's an IT consulting company. Today, with revenue closing coming close to 1 million euros every year, very soon we'll touch this mark. And the business model is very simple. In the French market, whenever any company or any institution thinks that they are not able to find the right profile in the local French market, this is where MindLab comes into picture, and we find the right talent for them. Most of the time we find the right person in India, but this right person that we find in India is lacking a little bit in the French culture and French language. So we groom that person in these two aspects. We sponsor the visa, work visa for that person, bring him to France, and then he or she, they work for our French clients. And we try to create a win-win situation for the French industry, for the Indian talent, and we connect the dots, basically. And then later on, I started some other real estate companies. Again, the idea was to solve a problem which was many Indian students were facing. So a lot of Indians are coming these days, and France being a very conservative country, the rules are very strict and structured approach is followed here. So it's very difficult for Indian students to find, you know, accommodation and good accommodation. So the idea was to solve that problem. And I started two real estate companies, and we're trying to solve that problem. And very recently, we started also a small mini venture capital fund, you can say. And I chose the name of the company as Corporate Yogi, because the inspiration comes from that yoga training that I did in 2015. So that's my journey.
It was so inspiring to hear your journey, and I salute your courage, because apni purani job aapne chhod diya. Your story reminds me a little bit of the novel The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari.
I haven't read that book, but yeah, I have heard about it, so maybe I think I'll have to read it.
So I again welcome you on our show, and it is so I think it was inspiring not only for us but also for our audience to hear about your journey.
Thank you.
तो पंकज जी, आप आपकी स्टोरी सुन के बहुत अच्छा लगा, और हमारा एक इमोशन कनेक्ट भी हुआ आपके इस जर्नी में कहीं ना कहीं, क्योंकि हम सब जो स्ट्रगलिंग करते हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं हम आपस में एक दूसरे से कनेक्ट जरूर होते हैं. और उसमें आपने एक और बहुत अच्छी बात बोली कि आप योगा आप करते हैं, योगा ने आपको बहुत एनकरेज किया. तो यहाँ मैं एक एड ऑन करना चाहूँगा, क्योंकि मैं खुद भी योगा करता हूँ, और मतलब योगा से हम सबसे पहले अपने आप को अपने आप का एहसास होता है योगा से. एक कहावत है कि सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन बिफोर गॉड रियलाइजेशन. तो हम पहले अपनी पहचान करें, फिर हमें भगवान की भी पहचान हो जाती है, और फिर हमें दुनिया की भी पहचान हो जाती है, और हम हर जगह सक्सेस हासिल करते हैं, जिसका एक प्रैक्टिकल एग्जांपल आप हमारे सामने रखें. तो ये एक मैं अपने ऑडियंस से बोलूंगा कि बहुत समझने वाली और बहुत गहरी बात है कि योगा का कितना इम्पोर्टेंस है हमारे लाइफ में, क्योंकि योगा से हेल्थ भी है, और हेल्थ है, और मेंटल हेल्थ है, फिजिकल हेल्थ है, और हम हर चीज को एक कामयाबी की नजर से देखते हैं और कामयाब होते हैं. तो
बिल्कुल सर.
जी, तो इसी के साथ हम शुरुआत करते हैं. तो पंकज जी, सबसे पहले हमारे ऑडियंस को आप ये बताएं कि आपने जैसे बताया 2006 में आप फ्रांस गए थे, राइट?
जी बिल्कुल जी.
तब में और अब में वक्त के साथ बहुत सारे बदलाव आए, और आपने काफी स्ट्रगल भी किया फ्रांस जाने के लिए, और मैं समझता हूँ कि ओवरसीज में फ्रांस एक ऐसा है जो जो बहुत डिफिकल्ट है बाकी के कंपैरिजन में, बाकी की कंट्रीज के कंपैरिजन में फ्रांस में सेटल होना बहुत डिफिकल्ट है. तो तब में और अब में क्या फर्क आया है, क्या कुछ आसान हुआ है, पॉलिसीज में आसानी हुई है, या कुछ गाइड करें आप हमारे ऑडियंस को जो इस तरफ अपना कैरियर बनाना चाहते हैं.
बिल्कुल सर. सर, आई केम इन 2006
जी.
तब से अब तक तकरीबन आप समझ लो 15 साल के आसपास हो गए, 15 साल से ऊपर, और मैंने फ्रांस को बदलते हुए देखा है अपनी आंखों से. 2006 में जब मैं आया था, तो अगर आप फ्रेंच नहीं बोलते हो तो आपके लिए जीना ही बहुत मुश्किल है. आपको छोटी से छोटी चीज, अगर आपको टेलीफोन कनेक्शन भी लेना है, उसमें एक एक महीना लग जाता था विदाउट एग्जाजरेशन. ठीक है. तो और उसका एक रीजन है, फ्रेंच जो लोग हैं दे आर वेरी अटैच्ड टू देयर लैंग्वेज एंड देयर कल्चर, एंड आई सैल्यूट देम फॉर दिस. ये जज्बा जो है हर देश के नागरिक में होना चाहिए, किसी भी देश के नागरिक में अपने देश के लिए ये जज्बा जो है, ये रिस्पेक्ट जो है, बहुत काबिले तारीफ है. पर उसका एक नेगेटिव इम्पैक्ट ये हुआ कि वो लोग ये समझते थे, सी 2006 तक ग्लोबलाइजेशन आ चुकी थी पिक्चर में, राइट? एवरी कंट्री अंडरस्टूड दैट यू नो दे कांट ग्रो ऑन देयर ओन, दे हैव टू एक्सेप्ट ग्लोबलाइजेशन. एंड आप अगर आप 2006 में आप यहाँ आए होते तो आपको ये लगता कि फ्रांस इज प्रोबेबली द कंट्री हु इज नेगेटिंग दिस फैक्ट कि ग्लोबलाइजेशन तो कुछ है ही नहीं, उनको खुद से ही लेके चलना है अपने देश को. तो ये बहुत जो कंजर्वेटिव था अप्रोच, वो मैंने चेंज होते हुए देखा है. आई वुडेंट से कि फ्रेंच लैंग्वेज की कदर कम हो गई है आज की डेट में, या फ्रेंच कल्चर की या लैंग्वेज की, ऐसा नहीं है. बट पीपल आर ओपनिंग अप, और मुझे लगता है कि इसका जो श्रेय है, मोस्ट ऑफ द क्रेडिट गोज टू द न्यूली इलेक्टेड फ्रेंच प्रेसिडेंट मिस्टर इमैनुअल मैक्रों, बिकॉज ही इज नॉट ओनली द यंगेस्ट फ्रेंच प्रेसिडेंट, बट ही इज ऑल्सो फ्रॉम द कॉरपोरेट वर्ल्ड. ही इज अ फॉर्मर इन्वेस्टमेंट बैंकर, तो वो समझते हैं इकोनॉमी को. आई थिंक उन्होंने कई ऐसी पॉलिसीज बनाई हैं, कई ऐसी स्ट्रेटजीज बनाई हैं, चाहे वो टैक्सेशन से रिलेटेड हो, चाहे वो एफआईआई फ्लोज को अट्रैक्ट करने के लिए हो, चाहे वो स्टूडेंट्स को अट्रैक्ट करने के लिए हो, चाहे वो इन्वेस्टर्स को अट्रैक्ट करने के लिए हो, हर फ्रंट पे उन्होंने इतनी अच्छी अच्छी स्ट्रेटजीज बनाई हैं. और उनको बनाया नहीं, उनको इम्प्लीमेंट भी किया और उनका असर भी दिखा है यहाँ पे.
तो मिस्टर धवन, 2015 में आपकी एंटरप्रेन्योरियल जर्नी शुरू हुई, आपने अपनी पहली कंपनी तब एस्टैब्लिश करी. आपका खुद का एक्सपीरियंस कैसा रहा फ्रांस में, विद फ्रांस बीइंग अ क्लोज निट कम्युनिटी, द फ्रेंच बीइंग अ क्लोज निट कम्युनिटी, एंड एक फॉरेनर के लिए, नॉन फ्रेंच स्पीकिंग इंडिविजुअल के लिए, हाउ वाज इट टू एंटर दिस वर्ल्ड एंड हाउ वाज इट टुडे इन 2021?
So, Dravyaji, I started in 2017, even though I created my company a little bit earlier, but I started running it as an entrepreneur from 2017 onwards. I would say, given that I spoke French, I mean, I understood and I was well versed in French, I would say. And given that I had already stayed almost like, you know, 10 years in France, I wouldn't call that it was a breeze for me starting a business. And I think there are two, three reasons for that. Number one, I would say the French language definitely, even though I knew the terminology. But I had to read a lot, understand, you know, different nuances, starting from the very beginning. You know, the first question an entrepreneur would ask, you know, what kind of legal structure should be adopted when you start a company. Just to answer that question, you know, I had to read a lot. I had to understand, you know, many things, many aspects, because generally whenever an entrepreneur starts, you know, he doesn't have many, you know, much finances. So you are your own lawyer, you are your own accountant, and you are your own advisor in some sort. So I had to read a lot, which I think would be a big challenge for any foreigner who is starting a business in France. But I would say I was lucky that I spoke French. Second, I would say administration. France, again, is not far from India as far as the bureaucracy is concerned. Unfortunately, it is one thing I think French really need to improve a lot. And I hope with digitalization, they might improve. But as of in 2017 and even today, I would say French bureaucracy is very cumbersome, very lengthy. And the reason is that it is very structured and elaborative. So we can understand, you know, if whenever we have something very structured and elaborative, it's going to be, you know, like cumbersome. Even if you consider the ease of doing business, I think France is not in the top 10 countries. It's probably near 40th or something. And the third, I would say, you know, the cultural aspect, France being a close-knit country, I think that is one of the biggest challenges, because if you have the right network, let's say you have a good lawyer, you have a good accountant, even if you don't speak much French, you can, you know, still overcome these hurdles. But finally, you have to do the business, right? And you have to do the business in the country. So you need to understand how French think. And I think even after staying 15 years, I have not been able to decode the French mentality as a French person at par, I would say. So I think the biggest difficulty for me and for any entrepreneur would be the decoding the French culture. I'll give you probably some examples, you know, to take it on the factual basis. So, you know, you wake up in the morning and let's say you have some meetings today with maybe your, you know, bank or business partner, or maybe with some clients. So France is known for, you know, luxury and elegance. And you have to really pay attention to that. So you have to wear good clothes. It don't have to be, you know, necessarily a good, you know, very expensive brands or something. But you have to make sure that, you know, you are well groomed. and you are well dressed, especially for the high level meetings. Okay. Second is that you have to understand the value of time. You have to be very punctual. Even though there is a cliche, you know, that says, you know, French are always late. But I would say, leave it aside, let them be what they are. But you are coming to France, you know, France is your target audience. So give value to time, especially in India. Unfortunately, we don't give value, that much value to time. So I think this is one thing we as Indians must learn, especially when doing business in France or in Europe in general. So give value to time, be punctual. And third thing I would say, don't straight jump, you know, straight to the point. Why? Because as far as I have understood, the social behavior in France is human-centric. And French people don't like, you know, when any foreigner comes and, you know, jumps straight to the business. They want to understand who you are first. So they are like a closed shell. You have to open up yourself first so that they can open up their self, you know, with you. You might have to, you know, go on business lunches, for example. Very, very important for any entrepreneur to do business in France is the business lunch or maybe drinks in the evening, if possible. And talk about, you know, French people, like I said earlier in my interview, that they love their culture, they love their language, okay? So you have to talk about the French culture, you have to talk about wine, you have to talk about food, you have to talk about French beauty, you have to talk about, you know, history of France, arts and everything, you know. You can even talk about a little bit, you know, your personal stuff. You can share things about India or, you know, any other country you're coming from. Basically, you have to open up and talk indirectly about many other things before, you know, straight jumping onto the business.
That is something about French culture.
Yeah.
So, seeing in 2021, देख रहे हैं कि काफी students France जाते हैं पढ़ने के लिए. It's picking up as a major education hub. So, any student who's inclined towards being an entrepreneur, has that entrepreneurial spirit, उनको आप क्या tips देंगे एक successful career के लिए? France,
आपने बिल्कुल सही पॉइंट बोला है. एजुकेशन वाइज फ्रांस इज पिकिंग अप अ लॉट दीज 5-7 इयर्स. आई हैव सीन मल्टीफोल्ड, यू नो, आई वुड से ग्रोथ इन देयर स्टूडेंट इनटेक, स्पेशली फ्रॉम इंडिया. आई थिंक पहले मैं थोड़ा सा इसके बारे में बताना चाहूंगा कि ये क्यों हुआ है. मतलब इन 2015 अराउंड 300,000 3 लाख स्टूडेंट्स आते थे फ्रांस में, ओवरऑल, यू नो, ग्लोबल स्टूडेंट्स. एंड अमंग दोस 300,000 स्टूडेंट्स, इंटरनेशनल स्टूडेंट्स, ओनली 1%, 3,000 इंडियंस वर कमिंग. ओके. एंड आई थिंक इट वाज वन ऑफ द टारगेट्स ऑफ फ्रेंच प्रेसिडेंट इमैनुअल मैक्रों, बिकॉज दे नाउ अंडरस्टैंड दैट द डेमोग्राफिक ऑफ फ्रांस is not suitable for ingrown growth. Okay, in a sense that, you know, if you see the details about the demographics, the population, I think more than 40% of the population is above 50 years old. So French now understand that, you know, to grow their economy, they need, you know, good talent. And the good talent, the start of the good talent is from the education only. So probably they have made different strategies, and India is no different, especially because of the bilateral ties of France and India as well. So I think they made the target that they need to triple the intake within 3-4 years, which they did. In 2019, they achieved the target of having 10,000 Indians per year. And I think now the new target of French embassy is around 20,000 Indians per year. And the target is, I think it's set for 2023, which I think I'm sure they will achieve. So they are doing it, that's for sure. Now, coming to the second part of the question, that Indians are coming. It's a pity that many Indians are coming, but we are not seeing much of, you know, entrepreneurship ventures in France from Indian community. And I think if I have to give some tips, the first and the multi-million dollar tip I would say is understand, I mean, learn French language and invest some time to understand the French culture, because that is the key to success in France. Unfortunately, you have to do it because you have chosen to come to France. Nobody asked you to do that. And if you have done it, be accept the fact that, you know, French are like this. And if you have to succeed, you will have to spend some time. So I would say if you're very busy in your curriculum or something, or if you're working and you have an entrepreneurial spirit, in that case, maybe reduce your efforts towards your studies or, you know, your professional career by 10 to 20%, but make sure that you are not lagging in learning French language and French culture.
Jo students wahan business start karna cha rahe hain, unke liye aap kya tips denge? How to go about it?
To ek bahut achhi baat hui thi jab Modi ji aaye the France mein. जनरली जो इंडियन स्टूडेंट्स आते हैं या तो बैचलर्स करने आते हैं या मास्टर्स, मोस्टली मास्टर्स करने ही आते हैं यहाँ पे स्टूडेंट्स एजुकेशन वाइज. तो इफ दे हैव डन देयर स्टडीज मास्टर्स और एमबीए और एनीथिंग फ्रॉम ए रेप्यूटेड स्कूल, दे गेट अ वर्क वीजा आफ्टर कंप्लीटिंग देयर स्टडीज. एंड जनरली दिस वर्क वीजा विच इज कॉल्ड APS यूज्ड टू बी फॉर 1 year. And after the visit of our respected Prime Minister Modi ji, I think India was the first country for which France increased this duration to 2 years. So I think that was one thing which is very good, and it is still there. So Indian students, they get 2 years of work permit during which they are considered at par with the French people. Whether they have to find a job or something. For example, in early days in 2006, any French company, if they wanted to hire any foreigner, for example, the process was very lengthy. So they had to publish in the newspapers that they want to hire somebody. They had to prove that they are not able to find local peoples. But now during, in 2021, during this APS, time of 2 years, you are considered at par with a French person. That means any company who wants to hire you doesn't need to do any, you know, paperwork or any efforts or any proof. They don't have to submit. Now, coming to the entrepreneurship, if Indian students are interested in entrepreneurship, again, this APS visa allows them to start a business. Now, there are two broad categories if they want to start their business. One is that if you want to start a business as a freelancer or something, for example, in web designing or something, then there is something called micro enterprise. Okay, it's a special status invented by the French government, and it's very easy to get that kind of business started because you don't have to do much. You just have to make a business plan. You need to prove to the authorities that your business plan is sound enough and you are able to get at least 18,000 euros of revenue per year. So that is one category. And the second category is if you want to start, you know, your startup or something. In that case also, you just need to make your business plan and submit it to the French authorities. And if you are able to convince them that your business plan is good enough, you can get entrepreneur visa in France. And I wouldn't stop here. The French government has revamped and overhauled their immigration rules to such an extent that even a true entrepreneur sitting in India, if he or she wants to come to France and start a business, in 2021, it is feasible and it is not at all complicated. I'll give you why. You just need to have either a master's degree in India or 5 years of experience. You need to have a solid business plan and you need to invest only 30,000 euros in France to start your startup. And you can be granted a special, you know, entrepreneur visa under the talent passport category.
I think that's very informational and something that could be really helpful for the Indian students in France. Moving on to our next question, current Indian government is very proactive and they're also bringing new policies to reform the way business is done in India. And the Federation of Indian Industry, it also serves as an advisory between government and businesses. So would you like to share a few things or ideas which could be implemented by the Indian government?
Yes, definitely. I'm a big fan of Modi ji. Mujhe lagta hai ki unhone kafi policies jo hain banayi hain jo ki proactive hain, business friendly hain, India ki economy ko aage le jane ke liye bahut zaruri hain. फिर भी मैं एक चीज बोलूंगा जो मैंने यहाँ फ्रांस में रहकर देखी है फ्रेंच गवर्नमेंट की हाउ दे ऑपरेट. इन वन वर्ड इफ आई हैव टू से आई वुड से ब्रांडिंग. यू नो फ्रेंच गवर्नमेंट एंड फ्रेंच एंटरप्रेन्योर्स बोथ आई थिंक इट्स इन द फ्रेंच डीएनए आई वुड से ब्रांडिंग समथिंग इज व्हाट दे डू. I'll give you many examples. You know, I'll start with something from the entrepreneurship domain and then I'll come to the government arena. Let's say champagne. Okay, champagne is nothing but a sparkling white wine. But what champagne is a sparkling white wine which is produced in the Champagne region in France. It's called champagne, nothing else. So it's kind of a, you know, patent you can say, or, you know, branding you can say. And worldwide it is consumed and champagne comes only from France. Okay. I'll give you one very good example of branding. There is an entrepreneur called Eric Bompard. Okay. He traveled in Asia. He went to India. He spent a lot of time in India and he understood that Kashmiri wool, you know, cashmere that they call in French, is very expensive and very luxurious. And not available in, you know, a lot of quantity. And he then started a company with his own name, branding he did, you know. And today they are selling, you know, Kashmiri sweaters and everything in France. And it is one of the premier brands in this domain, Kashmiri wool. Okay. Just to give you an example, a Kashmiri sweater is sold for a starting price of 150 euros, which is around, you know, 14,000-15,000 rupees. So a French person is able to go to India and take an Indian stuff and brand it on the world stage. So I think definitely there is something we need to learn from, you know, this French speciality, you know, how they do things. I'll give you some examples of, you know, French government, for example. Take for example, you know, Alliance Française. Alliance Française is an organization which is run under the patronage of French government. It's an institution which is specialized in teaching French. Okay. And no one in the whole world is being able to compete with the quality they are giving. It's a brand in itself and it's on the top. Okay. Take some other examples like tourism. To promote tourism, they have created another brand like Atufos, okay, and they are also doing their very best in promoting. They also have, for example, of Chamber of Commerce and Industry in France, and in every country they have set up their chapter, so they are also doing decent jobs. Mujhe lagta Modi ji ne bhi bahut acche kaam kiye hain. Yoga Day was proposed by Modi ji during the United Nations General Assembly back in 2014. Yoni ki wajah se hai ki Yoga Day ek brand ban gaya hai, right? But bahut aur sari cheeze ki ja sakti hain. Jaise Yoga Yoga Alliance ek organization hai which is recognized by the Indian government. But mujhe lagta hai ki agar aisi koi ब्रांड डिपार्टमेंट अगर मोदी जी बनाए या करंट गवर्नमेंट इंडियन गवर्नमेंट बनाए जिसका काम यही हो कि जो आइडियाज हैं उनको वर्ल्ड लेवल पे लेके जाना है, उनकी एग्जीक्यूशन इतनी अच्छी होनी चाहिए और उसका कंट्रोल जो है गवर्नमेंट के पास भी होना चाहिए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल योगा इज एन एंशंट, यू नो, इट्स अ वैल्यूएबल गिफ्ट फ्रॉम द, यू नो, एंशंट इंडियन ट्रेडिशन. एंड योगा अलायंस इज गिविंग द सर्टिफिकेट्स टू योगा schools to certify that, you know, person who is doing, let's say, 200 hours of training is a yoga teacher. And it is an institution, even though I think it is headed by an Indian, but the Indian government doesn't have much role to play in it, which Indian government could have, you know, played if the idea was to, you know, to take an inspiration from the French culture and use branding as a very, you know, strong tool in taking things to the world level.
Yeah, I think that's a very fair point and something that the Indian government could really implement.
So, Pankaj ji, today's session was very good. In terms of guidance, in terms of moral, and I understand that our audience will get a lot of clarity and will be able to make their career banana chahte hain overseas, especially in France. उनको एक कंप्लीट गाइडलाइन मिल गई होगी कि उनको क्या क्या स्टेप्स उठाने और हर हफ्ते कोई ना कोई इंडस्ट्री एक्सपर्ट हमारे साथ आते हैं जो हमारे लिए बहुत ही रिस्पेक्टेबल होते हैं और आज लेकिन आप एक खास अहमियत लेकर आए आप हमारे लिए बहुत ही खास इम्पोर्टेंस रखते हैं इसके कारण है कि एक तो आप इंडियन हैं और फ्रांस में आपने अपना नाम रोशन किया है आपने एज एंटरप्रेन्योर आप एक सक्सेसफुल बने दूसरा आप हम सब के लिए एक मॉरल है क्योंकि ओवरसीज में जाकर एक इंडियन को कितना स्ट्रगल करना पड़ता है ये हम सब बहुत अच्छे से जानते हैं और बहुत ही कम लोग होते हैं जो कामयाब होते हैं और तीसरा आप FII के साथ जुड़े हैं और एज ए वाइस प्रेसिडेंट आप वहाँ पे इंडिया को रिप्रेजेंट कर रहे हैं तो हमारे लिए बहुत ही ऑनर की बात है आज आपके साथ इंटरेक्ट करना और मैं समझता हूँ हमारे ऑडियंस तो आज उनकी सारी जितने भी क्वेरीज होंगी सॉल्व हो गई होंगी लेकिन फिर भी मैं अपने ऑडियंस से कहना चाहूँगा कि अगर उनकी कोई भी क्वेरी हो या कोई आप में से स्टार्टअप हो या अपनी एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप की जर्नी फ्रांस से शुरू करना चाहता हो और उनकी कोई क्वेरी बाकी हो वो कमेंट बॉक्स में जरूर मेंशन करें हम पंकज जी से रिक्वेस्ट करके एक एपिसोड और बनाएंगे आपके लिए तो आज इसी के साथ ही मैं इजाजत चाहता हूँ नमस्कार
थैंक यू नमस्कार Thank you.